everyone. Welcome to English Grade 4. I am Miss Wendy. Today, we will practice Test 2. So now let's start with Part 1. Part 1. Look and read. Choose the correct words and write them on the lines. There's one example. Look at example. It's a car. You have to pay the driver some money to ride in it. Now, look at the pictures and the words. So which one that you have to pay money? Yes, a taxi that you have to pay money to the driver. So, the answer is a taxi. Now it's your turn. Number one, it has two wheels. You have to wear a helmet when you're riding it. So, which one that you have to wear a helmet? A school bus? No. A helicopter? I don't think so. So, the answer is a motorcycle. Are you right? Good job! Now, we come to number two. Number two, you usually see it flying in the sky. It can carry lots of people. So, which one that carry lots of people and fly in the sky? A helicopter. But a helicopter cannot carry lots of people. So now, can you choose? Yes, a plane. A plane flying in the sky, and a plane can carry lots of people. Now we come to number three. It has four wheels and many windows. Students go to school on this. Students, school. So easy. A school bus. Good job, students. So now you come to number four. It flies in the sky too, but it can carry only two or four people. As I told you, which one do you remember? Yes, a helicopter. Now, number five, last one. It has two wheels, one on the left and one on the right. It needs a horse to run. Can you see a keyword in this sentence? A horse. So we will choose a horse bus. Well done, students. Okay, so now let's come to part two. Part two. In this part, you are going to read the questions and choose the best answer, A, B, or C. Now, part two, read the text and choose the best answer. Peter is telling his friends about his day at the toy store. I will do an example for you. Look at the example. Dad asked Peter, "Where did you go last Sunday, Peter?" Peter said, "I can play the piano," or "I went to a toy store," or "I like ice cream." So which one that you choose? Yes, the answer is B. I went to a toy store. So why is B? Because did that you choose something in the past. Did here, something in the past. A, I can, no, this is at present. C, I like ice cream. This one at present too. So only B is in the past. So we chose B. Now, it's your turn. Number one, what's the name of the toy store, Peter? A, it was next to our school. B, I was very happy. C, it's called Happy Land. So, which one is the best answer? Good job! The answer is C. So, now you can see here, the name When you see the name you have to choose is called Happyland is the name. Now move to number two. Number two, were there lots of children there? A. No, there isn't. B. Yes, it was sunny. And C. Yes, there were more than 10 children. Can you do it? It's easy. So the answer is C. Good job. Yes, there were more than 10 children. Now we come to number three. Number three, what did you buy? A. Mom bought me a toy horse bird and a toy helicopter. B. Yes, it was good. And C. No, I didn't. So which one that you choose? What did you buy that you have to choose something in the past? But A. In the past. B. In the past too. And C. In the past too. But look at this. What? So what that you have to choose? A. Good job, students. Next one, number four. Number four, did you like the toys your mom bought you? A. Yes, I did. B. Yes, she did. And C. Yes, she has. So did you like, so you have to choose something in the past too, but only A and B are in the past. So which one that you choose, A or B? Good job! The answer is A. Yes, I did. Now we come to number five. Did you buy a toy trolley too? Yes, I have. No, I had one at home. No, I don't. This one is in the past too. Did you buy? So A is at present. C is at present, so only B is in the past. No, I had one at home. So the answer is B. Good job, students. Number six. Was your dad there too? A. No, he couldn't. B. Yes, he was. And C. He doesn't know. Was your dad there? That you have to choose yes or no. So only A and B. So which one that you choose? A or B? Good job! The answer is B, because was your dad. So you have to choose yes, he was. Excellent! Now look at part 3. In this part, you are going to read the story, then you will choose the correct words here to complete that story. So I will do an example for you. Look at the example. Yesterday, it was raining heavily. David and Tom couldn't play outside, so they stay at Harry's house to games. So now, you need a verb here. So games, can we eat game? No, we couldn't eat game, so we will play game. And the answer is play games here. Now it's your turn. Number one. Harry had lots of toys that he loved very much. Then Harry had an idea. He put on his toys in the middle of the and talked to his friends. So in the middle of the, so you have to choose a place. Excited is a place? I don't think so. Wings is a place? No. So which one is the place? Good job! Room is the place that you have to choose in the middle of the room. Now, we come to number two. Number two, let's play a guessing game, said Harry. These are all of my transportation toys. I will say something about one toy And you will have to guess which toy I was talking about. Sure, said Tom and David. They were very with the game. So, let's see. When you play game, how do you feel? Good job, you feel excited. So excited is exactly the answer here. Good job. Now we come to number three. Number three. This toy is a transportation. It can fly. It has two big and a tail, said Harry. So, two big. Good job. Wings is the answer. Two big wings. Now we come to number four. Number four, Tom jumped and shouted to his friends, I know, Isa. Wow, you're super fast, said David. You win. So can you tell me the answer here? Isa. So we need to choose a transportation has two wings. So which one has two wings? Good job. It's a plane. Now we come to number five. Number five, the boys, happily, they kept on playing the guessing game until the train stopped. So the boys, here that you need to choose a verb. So which one is the verb? Play, laughed. So you have to choose a verb in the past. So here, laugh. This is the verb in the past. Now number six. Look at number six. It's very different. Number six that you have to choose the best name for the story. So, can you choose it? One, fun game at Harry's house. Two, the plane has two wings. And three, David is fast. Which one that you choose the best name? Good job! The best name is here, Fun Game at Harry's House. Look at part 4. In this part, you are going to read My City Has a Story. And then you will choose the correct words to fill in the blanks. I will do an example for you. Look at the example. My city is very old. My grandpa told me that 60 years ago, there any modern planes. There were some horse buses and lots of bicycles. So there were, or there was, or there weren't. Remember, in Unit 11, when you see any, that you have to choose there weren't. So the answer is weren't. Can you do it? Now it's your turn. Number one. Many people had to walk or ride their bikes because or and or but they didn't have money to buy motorcycles. So which one that you choose? Tell me. Yes, the answer is because. Now we come to number two and three. When my grandpa was young, he always walked the river near the house to get home from school. So now look at here. Walked in the middle of? No. Walked along. Yes, the answer is walked along the river. So can you walk at the top of? I think it's very difficult. So now, next one, number three. To get home after school, or to get home at school, or to get home in school. So which one that you choose? Tell me. Yes, the answer is after school. So So number two, we will choose along. And number three, we will choose after. Good job, students. Now we come to number four. Number four. 10 years later, the school wasn't there anymore, and Grandpa, a motorcycle. He rode his bike to work every day. There were lots of cars, buses, and taxis on the street. The city got crowded day by day. Now, look at this. We have had, has, and have. So, which one that you choose? Good job! Had. Because that we have to choose something in the past. And only had is talk about the past. Now, number five. Although the city had so many changes, my grandpa still loves it a lot. The city, was very beautiful in the past. It's getting more and more beautiful now, said Grandpa. This city. So this city, we will choose when? I don't think so, because when that you have to find something about the time. Who? This city and who? Who that you have to choose something about people. And only which is the best answer here. This city, which was very beautiful in the past. Good job, students. So now we will come to part 5. Part 5. In this part, you are going to read the story. There are 3 paragraphs in this story. This is the first paragraph. And this is the second one. And this is the last one. So you are going to complete the sentences below by using 1, 2, or 3 words. Now, I will do an example for you. Look at the example. It was last Sunday. So now, let's take a look at the first paragraph. Last Sunday, it was sunny. So the answer is here. It was sunny. So, I'll write sunny here. Next one, Holly and her family went to... Now, let's take a look. Holly and her cousins went to Green Museum. Can you see it? So, the answer is Green Museum. Now, it's your turn. Number one. The museum has many... Let's take a look. The museum was crowded that day. They saw many old things from the past. So the answer is old things. Good job, students. Number two. Trains, horse buses, trolley, and so on were things from. Let's take a look. Trains, horse buses, trolleys. So these things are from the past. So the answer is the past. Now we come to number three. They visited in the museum. Now let's take a look where they visited. There were many other places in the museum Holly and her cousins went to visit. So the answer is here, many other places. I will show you the answer. Other places or many other places, that's okay. Number four. When Max and Amy saw some funny trains from 100 years ago, they were. Let's take a look. Amy and Max were excited when they saw some funny trains. So the answer is here, excited. I will show you the answer, excited. Number five, there were from 100 years ago. So let's see. 100 years ago, 100 years ago is here. So they saw some funny trains. So funny trains is the answer. Some funny trains or funny trains, that's okay. Number 6. Amy wanted to whip an old motorcycle. Let's take a look. Leo was holding his skateboard when Amy saw an old motorcycle and asked him to take a photo. So the answer is here. Take a photo. I will show you the answer. Amy wanted to take a photo with an old motorcycle. Number 7. The man thought Leo's was 50 years old. So let's see what 50 years old. Look, this skateboard is 50 years old, shouted the man. So the answer is here, skateboard. So this is Leo's skateboard. I will show you the answer. The man thought Leo's skateboard was 50 years old. Okay, that's the end of part 5. Now we come to part 6. Part 6. You will look at the picture and the sentences below. You will answer the questions and write down the correct answer based on this picture. I will do an example for you. Look at the example. There is a on the table. Look at the picture. What can you see on the table? Yes, a CD player. Next one. The children are sitting in a... So can you see the children here? They are sitting in a circle. The answer is circle. Now it's your turn. Number 1. There are children at the party. So I think in this sentence that you have to count with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So there are 7 children at the party. Okay, now let's move to number 2. There a TV in the room. So what cannot you see in this picture? Yes, I cannot see a TV. So there isn't a TV in the room. Are you right? Good job! Okay, so now let's do number 3. In this number 3, you will answer this question. Where is the clown standing? Can you see the clown? Yes, he's here. So where is he? He is standing in the middle of the children. Number 4. What does the woman have in her hands? Can you see the woman? She's here. What's in her hands? Yes, sandwiches. So I will say, the woman has some sandwiches in her hands. Now we come to number 5 and 6. At number 5 and 6, you will write 2 sentences about the picture. But I will give you some recommended sentences for you. Look at the picture. The first sentence, they are having a party. And next one, there are 3 balloons in the room. 1, 2, 3 balloons. Next one, the children are watching the clown. The children here watching the clown. Next one, the boy wearing blue shirt is putting a disc into the CD player. And next one, the woman holding some sandwiches, she's here, is wearing a red sweater and a blue skirt. Next one. The clown is wearing a yellow hat on his head. And last one. The clown has a red nose. So that's the end of practice set 2. It's time to say goodbye and see you in the practice test 3. Goodbye!